Dr. Nicola, and I wanted to jump in to talk a little bit about how to authentically stay in a more positive mindset, or at least not let ourselves get trapped into negativity, because I think that's coming up for a lot of people. There's a lot of heaviness going on in people's world as we start shifting energies in the new year. And I was actually driving to work myself and had opinions around the other drivers on the road. And I realized and I remembered that the tool that I have to move out of that mindset of this isn't right, it needs to be different, what's this person's problem essentially, is simply choice. And I have a choice. I could stay in the energy of I have somewhere to be, I need to hurry up, I'm running late, you know, it needs to look like this. Or what, and this is what I did in the moment, was remember, wait a minute, I have a choice here. And I have a choice to perceive this as a barrier, or I have a choice to perceive this as an opportunity that slows me down and gives me a little bit more breathing room. I have an opportunity to say, you know, how somebody's driving is absolutely no reflection on their person. I have an opportunity to be in more my lightness, even as there's heavy energies moving through. Now, that's a relatively superficial example, but I think it applies, you know, even when things are a bigger, heavier, more emotionally charged issue, which is this idea of, you know, we can be in our lightness, even though the darkness is there or the heaviness is there. We can stay light, and that's by choosing, and that's also by using the word and. And this has been huge, because a lot of times, and I was helping somebody understand this yesterday, the mind is like, well, either you're annoyed at that person or you honor and send peace and love to that person that's driving in the car. But the heart is like, wow, I feel frustration and I feel peace and love emanating towards this other person in the car. And so it's a big and this is, can really drive anxiety, the mind's desire to say, well, do you feel this way or this way? Like, make up your mind. You know, are you happy that it's winter or do you not like winter? You know, you can't have both. Where the heart is like, wow, there's some aspects of winter that I love. And there's some aspects of this time of year that are really hard. You know, I feel oppressed in the cold, or I'd like it when there's more light outside, or at least here in Colorado, there's a lot of ice on the ground. So it makes it harder to walk and access, you know, nature, which is something that's a big part of our community here in Durango. And so, but it can be much bigger things like, I want to know more about what my husband's upset about, and I'm scared to death that something terrible might come if I ask, if I'm curious. And so the mind's like, doesn't allow you to know what to say when your partner comes home and they're really upset. But the heart goes, oh, there's both. You know, I'm deeply curious here, and I notice that there's some fear coming up around that. And once we can say, you know, use that and, it all of a sudden our system can relax, because there's room for it all. And our mind doesn't have to work so hard to figure out what needs to get cut and what needs to stay, you know, is the path ahead, and then spend a lot of energy when that other emotion comes in that got cut. It keeps on popping up and the mind's like, why is this still here? We made a choice about this. You can actually physically use your breath to bring you back into your heart center and allow you to expand into, there's plenty of room here, and I can feel all of these things. I can feel present, and I can feel excited, and I can feel hesitant, and I can feel distracted, and I can feel all of those things at the same time. The beauty of the heart, it is endlessly expansive. And as you move more into your heart energy, you will become aware of more energies that are present in your community, on the planet, in your family. And so just having more and more patience for yourself and choosing, oh, I didn't realize that I felt fear, I just thought I felt annoyed, is going, oh, okay. And I'm willing to love myself even though there's that fear there. There's confidence and fear. And that's okay. I'm okay with that. I'm willing to be with myself in this moment, as conflictual as it might be to the mind. So as we try to move through negativity and heaviness and old energies or difficult times, it's not so much about pushing them away. It's about saying, yes, this is here. And how is it a perfect gift for me in this moment? This thing I'm moving through is very hard to be with. And, what is it possibly teaching me? Or what else is possible for me if this is, if I'm willing to look at this or accept this as true? So I would love to hear about, what you think about that and some of the tools or tricks that you've learned to help you stay present to the fact that you always have a choice. And although it might not appear that way, there's always a choice. Or maybe even let me know if you feel like you're stuck and don't feel like there's a choice. I'd love to help you work it through. Thanks so much for joining, and I'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.